Hi guys, I'm here to walk you through multiviews. So with multiviews, we're going to expose this first. You are first going to look, there we go. Okay, you're going to first look at the introduction to multiviews. And this does have a lot of very useful text if you're not understanding the purpose of the assignment. And this object is really great with the colors. So you have to create a top view. So if you were, like, this is an object, it's a block. And if you're looking at the top, what you would see. If you're looking at the front of the object, this is what you would see. And if you're looking at the side, this is what you're seeing. Multiview is also really important to have everything lined up. So the outside of this line is lined up to the outside of this line. This is lined up right here. And these are also correlating in that way. They also are lined up to the side here. Notice how everything is arranged really well. You will have to do this with your designs. What else was I going to say? They're labeled and we'll go through that. So we're going to make this object here, and this has all of the dimensions on it, so you need to pay attention to that. I'm just going to put it off to the side here. I'm going to move this down here, so I am ready to go. Hey, school stuff. We are going to make our top view. So if I am looking at this object and looking straight down, I would see the top here, I would see this here, and I would see this here. So let's go ahead and do that. So it's, we know it's 2.25 and 5. So I'm just going to make a box that's 2.25 and 5. Let's check the line. You can also make a rectangle. And that's the rectangle. So you select the first corner or point, and I want to do dimensions, so I type D to give dimensions. The length of the rectangle is 2.25, and the width of the rectangle is 0.5, and then I have a beautiful rectangle. Now I'm going to see this next one, and I'm going to put the starting point. Where did my other rectangle go? I don't think I pressed enter. So I'll just do that real quick again. Specify first point. I press D, enter, 2.255, enter, and enter. Oh, I have to tell you where to go. Okay, so that was that. Then I'm going to specify this corner. And I'm going to go to dimensions, and this is 0.75 and 5. And I want that other corner to be there. So that's all I need for my top part. Now I just need to do the other part, which is another rectangle that is 2.75 by 0.75. So I'm going to do right here, click that. Click my dimensions again, 2.75, enter, 0.75, enter, enter. And that is my top view. Now I'm going to make my front view. So that's as if I'm looking at this side right here, and I'll see this bottom line as well. So this one is a little trickier, because I have to make some different triangles. I am gonna make sure I'm lined up. So I'm gonna actually give myself a guideline just down here so that I have an endpoint to start my rectangles. I'm gonna start by making this very little tiny rectangle here. I'm gonna click here, and I know it is the dimension of 2.75 by, I think it's, let's move it over. Yeah, 0.25. Enter, specify, right there. Look how easy this rectangle thing is. But now I'm going to do line, and I'm going to come up here. It is 1.5. Then I'm going to come over and be 2.25. Enter, I come down 0.75. I come over 0.75, and then I come down one and I connect it here. Now that was, I went really fast, I'm sorry. I went and I made these lines since this is the outline of the side view, the front view that I would see. And I'm going to delete my guideline for now. Now I'm going to make another guideline and come over here. And now I'm going to make my right side view. And you can do this with rectangles if you want, or you can just do lines, whatever you find easiest. I know I'm going to see this square or rectangle here, this rectangle here, and this rectangle here. So I'm going to go up 0.25, I'm going to come over 0.75, I'm going to come down 0.25, and then I'm going to come over, because that's this part here. Then I'm going to come up here, I'm going to go up one, over 0.5, down one, and over 0.5 again. And then I'm going to make my top rectangle by going up 0.75, over 0.5, and then down 0.75. Enter. So then I'm actually going to leave this here. Now this is a fun thing you can do. You can take your lines and you can change the color. So that's here, and I'm going to change it to be this bright blue because I want my guidelines or my lines showing how they are lined up to be blue, because I don't want them to be the same color as an object, because then it's hard to figure out what's the object and what's the line. So I want to be able to do it a little differently. I'm going to say for this, I do want this lined up here. So you want to make sure you have all these lines here. I'm going to select this line and this line and this line and this line, this line, because you can select more than one, and then you can make them all blue. And so now it tells like the object is definitely white and then the line is blue. Now to do text, you're going to come down here and you're going to choose multi-line text. You specify the first corner, specify the second corner, and then it should come up with a box that looks like this, just like this, and this is my top view. And then you can move it if you need to. And then you're just going to do that again. Come over here. And this is going to be my front view. Ooh, typing, not my favorite thing today. And then I click out to exit the type of the text. And then I come over here and I make my box and I make it right side. Yep, that was right, view. And then that's all I need to do for my multi-views assignment. I took an object and I'm making it this way. And I want you to kind of get used to this because it's going to be really helpful for our next assignment. Ooh, I forgot a line. This is what. That was me with my critical eye. So yeah, make sure you do that. And then you're going to come up here, go output, plot. It's plotting. It's thinking. Give it a second. You come down here, general documentation, window. And then, okay. Good luck, guys.